Are you sure you can maximize your window screen?
Hello, good afternoon to all the student teachers and parents joining on this session. Welcome to Mission AI Bootcamp number. Very good afternoon to Akhil, Guneet, Shiva, Ishika, Sakshi, Pahal. Very good evening, very good afternoon to all the students, teachers and parents who have joined us. We will be starting our session just in 2 minutes. We are just waiting other students to join. And it's really lovely to see all of you before time. Very good afternoon, Srishti. Very good afternoon, Ayush, Kevin. So till the time like other students are joining, I would like to ask some questions from you. Okay, so have you all downloaded the PictoBlocks? Can you please respond me on the chat? So yeah, thank you all students for your lovely wishes. Good afternoon to all of you. So I request you please answer the question, like have you all downloaded the PictoBlocks in your whether in your Android laptop, PC, in anywhere? Okay, I can see yes, no. So students who have not downloaded, please download it. If you want, we will just share you the link again. Okay, I can see some yes and some no's. So students, till the time, like we will be starting in 2 to 3 minutes. So I want all of you like to be equipped with the PictoBlocks. So please kindly download the PictoBlocks. So I'm just stopping your chat. Okay, and so that you can get the link here. So kindly please download it in your laptop PC with this link or in your smartphone. So I have disabled the chat for a few minutes, students. Okay. Yeah, I'll share the link so that like you can start working on it and download. For the students who are saying like if the problem is like you are not able to, like your mobile is saying that this application is not compatible. Okay, agar aapke phone mein aisa kuch aa raha hai ki like your mobile is not compatible with this, so I'll just share you a different link. Just give me a moment. if in case koi compatibility issue hai, so you can download it from this link. Okay, so this is a direct link, so you have to ask, like, give all the permissions by yourself. So we'll just wait a couple of minutes. It's already 3, so we'll start at 3:02. Okay. So I'll just check with, like, Pramod sir. Hello, Pramod sir. Is my voice audible to you?
Yes.
Okay. So students, if you're finding any problem in watching us or in hearing our voices, please click on reconnect button in front of you. आपके सामने जो reconnect button है, please उस पर click करिए, so that you connect to this live streaming back again. So I want, like as I said, within yesterday and today, we want everyone to be equipped with the PictoBlock. Sabke paas, whether it can be on Android or laptop or in desktop, sabke paas PictoBlocks hona chahiye, because this is very compulsory, because all the things we will be doing in this application. So we want you to work on it. And if you are facing any trouble, please feel free to share your screenshots on our WhatsApp number. I'll just share you my WhatsApp number again today towards the end. If in case you are not able to hear me or see me clearly, just please click on the reconnect button. So hope everyone has taken the links from here. So I'm just allowing your chat again so I can see your views. And okay, good. So if in case, as I said, like if you are stuck in using PictoBlocks, please share us the screenshot in our WhatsApp. I'll just share you my WhatsApp number towards the end of this session. We'll just starting in a moment, students. We want everyone to be get like join in the session. Okay, I can see so many. Yes, okay, wonderful. Yeah, so we'll just start. No, actually, we are not going to directly on Evive, but as I said, like we will be working from very basic in programming. Programming ke bahut hi basic concepts se we are going to start. And I will be also showing you the registration and the dashboard, also how you are going to work with the like daily assignments and everything. Okay. We'll just wait for a single one moment. Okay, and also a very one more important thing, all the students who were registered, like who have completed the registration, it's wonderful. If you have not completed registration, please try to get yourself registered on the website. Okay. And also please check your emails regularly. Okay, if it's your dads, if it's your parents, so please ask them to check and let you know about it. Because we are sending some of the notifications on email as well as the messages. So we are also trying to send you the messages on text. Okay. So please keep following those things. Okay. So I'll just request Pramod sir. Sir, we start. Hello, Pramod sir.
Yeah, Ayush, you can start the thing and we can focus on the session.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so now let's start with today's session. And like many of you might be very new to this session, okay? You might have not attended yesterday's session as well, but not a problem. We'll give you a short recap and you will be able to understand each and everything very easily. Okay, so I'll just start with the first of all again. So everyone has joined, maximum of you have already joined. So first of all, I would like to welcome again all you back on the Mission AI Coding Bootcamp. And I would also like to introduce to Mr. Pramod sir. He is the head in Center of Digital Technologies. And I have with me my mentor, Pankaj sir. So he is the Chief Technical Officer in STEMpedia. And my name is Ayush, and I will be your AI instructor for all these sessions and always be there to help you with all your queries. So let's start our today's session. So what exactly is Mission AI and what exactly the bootcamp schedule is going to be? What are the prizes? And also we are going to understand about the artificial intelligence. Why is it necessary? As I say, like advantages and application. Also, we are going to make some of the activities understanding the PictoBlocks program. So what exactly Mission AI is? So here is, we have came up with LBCMF coordination that we have came up with this mission to provide artificial intelligence education with hands-on experience to 1 lakh students through these boot camps all over the India, where we will be taking the sessions on game and animation, computer vision, face detection, object detection, machine learning, and speech recognitions. So this is a schedule for this boot camp which you have enrolled for here. So one inaugural session has already been completed. So today we are going to understand a concept for making an animation. Okay, like we will be making move the characters in the PictoBlocks. And you can see we will be having the sessions on 19, 20, 21. We will be having a day break on 22. And again, it will be started with 23. Also, you can see there is a 3-day time for making your final submissions. So in this bootcamp, you are automatically enrolled with the competition. Okay, and in this competition, we will be giving you time for 3 days to submit your final projects. And you can win exciting robotics kit. And results will be declared by the end of this bootcamp. So now let's talk about the prizes. So this is the prize for the winner. It's in Quirky Ultimate Kit with Mars Rover add-on. And you can make almost 30 to 40 good projects using this. You can see the Quirky Ultimate Kit. So there will be two runner-ups who will be awarded with this. Two second runner-ups who will be awarded with Quirky Innovator Kits. And there will be 5 consolation prize. They will be awarded with Quirky Explorer Kit. So I'd like to just show you a small video of these prizes and then we'll move ahead with the introduction to artificial intelligence. So this is a short video for the prizes to motivate you, to make you understand what exactly the pictures you have seen, how exactly it works in the real world.
Meet Quirky. It's a gesture-controlled robot. No. A smart gardening system? No, wait. An autonomous delivery truck? No. A Mars rover. Actually, it's all this rolled into one.
Hi, Quirky.
Hi, Jay.
It's an AI and robotics learning companion for the next generation. Quirky takes children on an exciting journey to explore advanced concepts on AI and robotics with an easy, engaging, and hands-on approach. It is packed with interactive online courses and engaging live sessions that help children to learn, code, and make their own real-world projects. In other words, one Quirky, endless possibilities. Quirky is portable. Carry Quirky around and control it using your laptop, tablet, or even a smartphone. It's easy to program, whether you're a coding newbie using blocks or an expert using Python. Comes with a plug-and-play interface, making it hassle-free, and with some of the coolest latest tech. So imagine a self-driving car, which identifies street signs and pedestrians. Or a faithful robot dog that follows commands with the help of machine learning and object detection. It's evident that Quirky is for everyone who wants to be ahead of the curve.
Ready to explore the universe of AI and robotics with me?
So I hope you have seen the video and you might have understood what exactly Quirky is. So let's start our today's session with the introduction of artificial intelligence. But before starting this, so let me ask you one question. So are you all ready to get these awards to you? Are you all ready? Can I have your yes in numbers? Okay. Okay, wonderful. Okay, I can see. Yeah. great. So this enthusiasm we want from you, not only to get awarded with the Quirky, but also for learning, completing assignments, and doing the hands-on activity daily with the PictoBlocks. Right. So it's wonderful to see so many yes. And I think I should start with introduction to artificial intelligence. So, Pankaj, should I start? Move ahead. Oh, great. So, students, okay. So, yeah, thank you for replying on the chat box. Now, I want you all to focus on the screen, okay? Because this is something we are gonna start making a foundation, okay? So first of all, I would like to welcome to all of you to the introduction of artificial intelligence. But again, I'll ask the same question. There is a small question. So how do you feel when you get all your questions correct in a tough exam? So can you answer me on the chat? So can you please answer me on the chat? So how do you feel if you correct all your questions in a tough exam? Okay, I can see proud, amazing, happier than ever, nice, very, very happy. Okay, wonderful, fabulous. Okay, wonderful. But we have taken these some of the parts yesterday also, but I wanted to cover this again so that you can feel what the flow of artificial intelligence and understanding what is the necessity of doing the programming and how we can do it in the PictoBlocks. Yeah, one of the feeling, the major feeling is also that we are intelligent. Yeah, so if I correct all the questions in a tough exam or I do solve a challenging puzzle in a record time, so I feel very intelligent. So now yeah, I can see some of have answered very that you feel intelligent. So Now let's understand what exactly is intelligence. So to make an activity, or I should say make projects in artificial intelligence, it's very necessary that we should understand the human intelligence. So to understand an human intelligence, you can see there are three steps where we perceive, understand, and analyze the information, learn and increase the knowledge, and make decision based on the knowledge. So I'll just explain you with a very short example, although we have already covered this example in yesterday's session. So those who want to get in deeper of that example can look on to the recorded session. So, but to make you understand all of these three steps is like anything, whenever you are seeing for the first time, so you give time for it and you take time to understand what exactly it is, like whether it can be from anything, from pen to like whatever you are seeing in front of you. After understanding and analyzing the information about it, you start learning and increasing the knowledge about it. Like if you have learned about any object, then you will start increasing your knowledge that what are the different sizes of this product or this object, what can be different colors of this object, what can be different sources of this object. Okay, and after that it comes like when the right time comes, you have to take the decision to use that object based on your knowledge which you have acquired from like increasing your knowledge. Okay, and this makes you intelligent. To just give you an example, as I said, so just think what happens when you enter in an when you enter to a new class. So like if you are in fifth, you will go to sixth. So first time when you are going to open the books, it's not like you are going to learn and understand each and every pages of the book, but you will start analyzing. So what are the subjects in this class? What are the syllabus of the subjects, right? And what are the different things I'm going to learn? And after that, you give a little time to every subject and start increasing your knowledge. And of course, like in the exams, the right time comes when you make a decision based on the knowledge, write your perfect answer and acquire a good marks. So this can be a very short example, but whether we know or don't know, but we follow these steps for doing everything, whatever a human wants to do in daily life. Now coming to the animal intelligence. So we have talked about human intelligence. Now let's talk about animal intelligence. So here you can see, students, animals are also intelligent. Okay, but animals are intelligent, but they are not good as humans, because in most of the animals, their skills and abilities are restricted to the survival. Okay, so they are not so intelligent that they can detect each and everything. They are just intelligent to make their survival possible. So okay, some of the good examples like dolphins, parrot, and elephants are one of those most intelligent animals. Birds. Now talking about an artificial intelligence. So student, what exactly is artificial intelligence? We have been hearing it from so long. So artificial intelligence is going to come bring a new era. It is going to bring something new to our world. But what exactly it is? So artificial intelligence is the design to design for intelligent computers, where like you can see, like as I said, the human intelligence, you first acquired some understanding, then you started increasing the knowledge and took the decision. In the similar fashion, what happened when computers started gathering an information by its own, analyzing and started making decisions by its own, and also started, and I should say, taking the like completing the task automatically based on the decision what the computer has taken, it made this computer an artificial intelligence. Because this was the definition for being an intelligent, that if you can take appropriate decision based on the knowledge. So now, of course, we have developed the artificial intelligence. So this is why we called it artificial. But of course, computers nowadays are getting more intelligent than human. Yeah, I can see like smart mobiles. Yeah, Ishan, it's correct. Like smart mobiles.
Hello, students. Can you hear me? Hello, students. Can you hear me? Yeah, I think you were gone for a few seconds.
Yeah. So now am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Yeah, you can.
Okay. So, like students, as we were discussing, yeah, I'm sorry, students. Like I just went out of the webinar due to some technical issues, but now I'm back. So now we were discussing about the application of artificial intelligence. So now you can see there are so many, basically the applications like gaming, making expert system, speech recognition, face recognition, text recognition, intelligent robots, and computer vision. And we will try to give you the hands-on on maximum of the things using PictoBlocks so that it becomes very much easy for you to understand artificial intelligence as well as develop your own project using it. Okay. So now you have already seen some of the examples which you are surrounded with are like Snapchat, where it uses a face recognition technique and it brings up the different filters on your face, where you have also seen the working of Alexa. It works on speech recognition. That is again a technique of artificial intelligence. You can see some applications in industrial use also. So industrial robot also use artificial intelligence. It can help industries to find those things which a human even it becomes difficult for human also. Like a robot can detect whether the cakes or the pancakes are baked or not. So it becomes even difficult for us to directly just see it and understand. But for robots, it becomes very much easy if they are using an artificial intelligence. Talking about the self-driving cars. So as the name suggests, self-driving cars are those which don't need a driver. So you might have heard of so many coming up, like one of the best, I should say, is the Tesla. We always hear in the news about Tesla. So yes, these are the self-driving car. We don't need a drivers because it is enabled with artificial intelligence. So it detects the different objects. Yes, Zafir has mentioned the name Tesla. Wonderful. So as I said, like what it does, what exactly it does and how exactly it works. So to make you understand this, there are so many concepts in self-driving cars, but some of them I would like to bring in your views. So one is object detection. So it detects the different objects surrounding it. Like you can see on the image, it is detecting person, it is detecting bus, it is detecting cars. All not only detects the objects, but also take the proper decision. Like if it sees that it has to turn right, so it will automatically turn right. If it sees a person is in front of the car, so it will automatically apply the brakes, right? So there are different sensors which are attached with artificial intelligence to make the car to take its own decision. Now, taking you to the next example. So this is something from the text recognition from image. So you might have used Google Lenses. So Google Lenses is one of the application of the text recognition technique of artificial intelligence. Where you, if you are going to put, if you are going to bring anything written or printed in front of the camera, your machine will be able to detect what exactly is written. Okay, so this helps you in so many ways. Like if you want to see applications of text recognition, the most and the common example you can see as a FastText. So you might have seen, you might don't know what exactly FastText, but let me tell you. So what happens generally, previously what used to happen in the tolls, like tolls in outskirts of the city, whenever you used to take the car or your bike, it they used to stop you and ask you for the money, then used to give you the slip. But using the artificial intelligence, what has evolved is the evolution has came up where it automatically detects the number plate, the number, and detects and deducts the money from your account and let you pass from the tolls. Okay, so I can see Tanu has made a written fast tag. Yeah, of course. So now let's understand what is program. So see, we have understood AI, we understood the applications, but how we are going to make this, right? So we need certain application on which we can develop. So we have that is PictoBlocks. But in PictoBlocks also, we have to program the things. Now, what exactly program is? So a program is a set of instructions that computer follows to complete a task. Like if I ask you to get me a glass of water, so what you're going to do? You are going to go to the kitchen, take a glass, fill it up with drinkable water and bring it to me. So these were the instructions followed by you. But if I ask the computer, can computer give me a water? Of course not. But there are some robots which can do this work, right? But if I talk about normal computers, which we have, as well as the Android, as well as the smartphones we have, we can get a calculation. Like you might have used a calculator. So you just give a number, put an operation, whether it's an addition, subtraction, or multiplication, division, and you take the output, right? So this is a set of program. This is basically the set of instruction which machine follows, that it will ask you for a number, then it will ask you for an operator, and in on the backside of the calculator, it will calculate everything and get you the result. So a program is a set of instructions that follow that a computer follows to complete a task. Now, a good program consists of three parts. First is planning, second is writing, and the third is testing and debugging. So what is planning? So student, planning is like, if we want something, right? So we plan for it. Like anything you want, if you want a good marks in the coming exam, or if you want to crack any opportunity, or if you want to perform good in a dance competition. So what do you do? So first part, what do you do is you plan that I'm going to dance this way. I'm going to use this song for the dance, right? Similarly, by programming also, we need to plan that what is the desired output, how you want your final program to work. After planning that, you start writing it. And we will be helping you with all this planning and writing and testing debugging PictoBlocks. So as I said, you will start writing. And in our case, you will be starting writing using the blocks. And after that, you will test it, that whether it's working fine or not, as you expected, right? So after that, if it is working fine, then it's good. If not, you will start debugging. And debugging means finding the error. Okay, so I think you have already downloaded the PictoBlocks. We have already shared you the link. I'll just share you the link once again so that you can be ready with the PictoBlocks.
You can start enable your camera, and the link is pinned as well. Mm-hmm. So you can move ahead.
Yeah. Okay. I won't be able to turn on my camera. Actually, I have no power here, but not an issue. I'll just start working on this introduction of the PictoBlocks, and I'll share my screen and show you all how exactly PictoBlocks look like, what are the different components and everything. Okay.
Close the chat because people are getting distracted.
Okay. Okay, so you have already downloaded the PictoBlocks. So let's start with what exactly is PictoBlocks. So students, PictoBlocks is a graphical programming software, okay, where we use a drag and drop operations. We drag some blocks and complete the programming. We don't need to memorize the different and typical syntaxes for making good program. And this is the finest way of making the animations, making games, as well as using an artificial intelligence. So I'll just directly share my screen and show you the PictoBlocks. So I hope my screen is visible to everyone.
Yes.
Okay, great. So student, this is the interface of the software. Okay, which is like right now I'm showing it to you from the laptop or a desktop, and I will be explaining you the parts in the phone also. Okay, so you don't have to worry with that. So let's first understand the basics, very basic, what exactly the PictoBlocks contains, what are the different components. So let's start with one of the most attractive thing which we can see on the screen is the teddy bear. So what exactly is this character? So students, all the characters in the PictoBlocks are called as sprite. So why do we need characters? So we need the characters to perform an activity. Like if we want to make any program, we want to see some output. So we will be in requirement of having some characters which say something, which can move from here and there and show us the final programming. So now so PictoBlocks come up with a rich library of sprite, and you can choose different sprite from this choose sprite option. So here students, you can see there is a library for sprite. You can choose anything what you want. We will be working with different sprites in different in the daily different sessions. For as of now, you can see I'm just still just using the Toby back again. So now you can see there are two Tobys. So here students, we can add as many we want different sprites. Okay, so we will be also telling you how you can work with multiple sprites in coming session, but for today we will be working with only one sprite. Now there is an option, students, that you can also paint your sprite. So if you are going to go in the paint option, you will find something like this, where you can paint your own sprite. Like if I want to make a small gate, okay? So this is like I have made just very roughly. So this is an sprite. So this is something I have made as a gate of a house. So this is a gate of a house. So in this way, we can make different sprites. We can paint our own sprite. If we want to make a sprite with the names and everything, can be done very easily. Also, you can paint the already existing sprites. Like you can see here, if I want to edit this, so how you can do it, you have to go and select the object. Like if I want to select this glasses, and I'll just delete this. So now you can see I have changed a little bit. Okay, even I can paint. So if I want to write T on its t-shirt, I can write it very easily, right? So this is how exactly you can paint the sprite and work with sprite in the PictoBlocks. Now coming to the second component, and you can see a white space just behind this Toby. So student, this is we called as a stage. Now right now you can see the stage is blank, but we can choose a background for the stage by an option of a backdrop. So here you can see there is an option of a backdrop. Again, it comes with a multiple options. So let's first see the option of a backdrop, where you can select it from the already existing library in the PictoBlock. So you can see there are different different backdrops. You can choose anything what you want. For as of now, I'll just choose beach. Okay, so now you can see it is moreover looking that the Toby is standing on the beach. Also, student, you can upload your own backdrops in the software. Like if you need, you can just click on this upload backdrop option, and you can select the files from your laptop or desktop. Now, students, let's come to the left-hand side of the PictoBlocks. So on the left-hand side of the PictoBlocks, you can see there are different blocks, and also all the blocks, you can see different palettes as well, like motion palette, look palette, sound palette, even palette. Okay, and every palette is associated with some of the blocks with the same color. So now you can see the motion palette is in blue color. So all the blocks under the motion palette are in blue color. Okay, and similarly, you can see the loops, you can see sounds, events, control. So I will be explaining you like daily some of the blocks which will enhance your library and understanding for all the blocks in the picto blocks. So we are going to use these blocks to program, to make a program. As I said, like we will be planning a program and then we will be writing it. So in the writing section, basically we are going to use this block. Now students, coming to the center part, you can see again a white space, and this is we called as in scripting area. So what exactly is scripting? Scripting is writing. Okay, it is just an another word you can say for writing the codes. So this is an scripting area and we make the scripts in this place. So just randomly, if I'm taking some of the blocks, okay, so I'm just randomly taking some of the blocks. So now I have written a small script in the scripting area. Okay, so hope now this script and scripting area concept is clear to all of you. Now students, let me start with one of the very basic program I wanted to show to you, and we will be taking care of some of the concepts in this, making this program. So as I said, there are three steps. So let's first plan what we want to make. So in planning, if I'm planning basically to make a program where I want to see my Toby walking on the beach. Okay, so this is my planning. Also, I also want like it should move from here to there. Also say hello to everyone. Okay, now the things come up that how we are going to use it. So students, we'll now start writing it. Okay, we'll start writing the program. So as I just thought of making my Toby move, or I should say making my sprite move from one place to another, I can see there is a motion palette which contains the blocks which will help me to give the motion to the sprite. So let's start with very first, that is move 10 steps. Okay, so this is like just by reading on the block, you can understand it is going to move my Toby or my sprite. So if I'm going to click it, you can see it is moving 10 steps on the beach. Now students, you just saw me that I was clicking again and again on this block. So, but if we are learning programming, so we are somewhere making the things work automatically. Right. So, but how we can make it work automatically? So students, there is a control palette, and in control palette, you are going to see a block forever. So as the name written forever, it means any blocks coming inside it will be executed again and again. And I'll just repeat this. So any blocks coming inside the forever block will work again and again. Okay. So how it can be done is just put this block inside the forever. And now let's see how exactly this set of blocks are going to work. So now you can see it is working, and of course it went till the end, but it got stuck, right? So I'll just bring it back. And now you are gonna see again that it is going till the end and again getting stuck. So student, this is the, you can see it as an error. Okay, so this is like a short error, but the things come up how we have to resolve it. So this was not we were supposed to get as a final output. We wanted that my Toby should move from here and there. So let's find a solution for it. So in the motion, you are gonna see a block which says if on edge, bounce. So if you are going to put this, if you are going to put this and start, let's start working of this set of blocks. So now you can see it is coming back as I wanted it to, but again, there is a small problem that it is coming up with a rotation. So now how can I solve this problem? So again, this will be solved under the motion, because this is related to the motion of the sprite, right? So here, there is a block which says set the rotation style, and you can see there are three different options in it: left to right, don't rotate, and all around. So I'll choose left to right, which will enable it to go from left to right instead of getting just all around. Okay, so now let's see whether it works or not. So now you can see I'm almost getting my results as I was planning, that it is moving from one place to another. Okay, but again, the things come up here is, like, did I exactly wanted my Toby to look like this? No, of course not. I wanted there should be an animation, there should be something like legs and hands moving here and there. It should look better, right? So how can I do that? So here, students, a concept comes of costumes. So what exactly the costumes are? The costumes are nothing but different pictures of the same sprite. So you can see there are different pictures, okay, in different positions of the same sprite. So this is something is Toby walking one, this is something Toby walking two, Toby walking three. Okay, this is, so now if I'm going to show you one thing, like, just please focus on the stage. Okay, just focus on the stage. And if I'm going to change the costume with my mouse, okay, from one to two, so you will be able to see that my Toby is moreover looking like it is talking to me, right? So why exactly I'm able to see this? Because I'm changing the costume. So now we will try to execute, we'll try to make this work using the blocks. So I'll go back to the code part, and in the code part, student, you will be doing these all work under the loops. So here you can see there is an option of switching the costume. Okay, so I just showed you doing it manually, like just by clicking on the different costume, but we will be doing it using our blocks. So I'll just bring a switch costume to Toby walking one. Okay, and I also need to switch it to the second costume. So I'll just bring one more block which says switch the costume to Toby walking two. Okay, and I'll put it here. Now let's see whether it's working or not, as I'm expecting. So again, you can see it's not exactly working how exactly I wanted it. But let me tell you, everything is working on this side, but these two blocks, which is switch costume from Toby, switch costume to Toby walking one, and switch costume to Toby walking two, are working in a such a high speed that we are not able to see the change in costume with our normal eyes. So here the concept of weight comes. So in the control, in the controls, there is a block which says weight, and it will help you to make stop anything, or you say, I should say not stop, but pause the things for a little bit. So I can just put a weight 1 second here, and I'll add a weight 1 second here. So how exactly it is going to work is, it will change the costume, it will pause for 1 second so that we can see the change. And again, it will take, it will change the costume to Toby walking two. And again, it will take a small pause, which will help me to see the changes. And now let's see whether it's work or not. So, so now you can see it's working, right? Not exactly how I wanted, but again, as I say, we need to test, debug, and find the resolution, find the answer to all the problems, right? So now you can see it's working, although very, very closely how I wanted. But still, to make it work much more better, what we have to do is, students, you saw that there was a change in costume. But at that time, what was happening? Toby was getting stuck at a place. So how we can solve that problem? So only thing is, I need to put a move 10 step at that time. Okay, and I'll jump. Restart this script, and you can see now it is moreover working how exactly I wanted. As I said, we also wanted that it would say hello to everyone while walking. So I can do that with a block in the looks palette, and I'll just bring say hello and put it here. So now you can see it is saying hello to everyone, right? Also, students, till now you have seen me just clicking on the script, but I would like to tell you, like, there are some more options in the picto blocks where you can maximize your screen or you can go to the full screen. So on the right hand side of the corner, you can see there is an option for full screen control. So if you're going to click on full screen, so now you can see it on a full screen, but the problems arrive here is that how I can play that script, because till now I was clicking on it, right? So, but for this, we have an option in events. So these are the blocks which helps to control the complete event. So here you can see this is when green flag is clicked, and you can see this is a green flag. So basically this block is going to activate this green flag. Okay. And we will be using very frequently this block, that is when green flag is clicked, almost in every script we are going to use it. So now, students, what am I going to do is I'm going to keep it full screen. I'm going to click on a green flag. So now you can see it is working and it is also saying hello to everyone. You might be thinking that what are the options over here on the screen? So student, these are the options. You can record the stage work, what is there on the stage. Okay, so you can just click on the start recording and you can the recording will automatically be started. And again, you have to click on the same button here to stop it. Also, you can take the snapshot or the screenshot, I should say, of the screen. And using these options, you can open the gallery. Like if I'll just click it here, it will direct me to the gallery of PictoBlocks where I can see the videos and the pictures which have been saved. So these are the videos which have of the previous, I should say, activity which I have recorded, and you can see it here, it is saved. Okay. So coming back to the main screen, and on the after the green flag, you can see a button here which says stop. So you can use this to stop. Okay, so now I think moreover this part is very clear to you. Okay, so you will be working with this in the coming time, and you will be learning so many things using it. Also, like if you have any doubt, you can put it on the chat. I'll stop my share as of now.
Ayush, can you put on the chat?
Yeah, yeah. Yes, sir, just a moment.
Yeah.
Okay, so can I have your responses, student? That is the things which I just showed you was clear.
Ayush, you can keep sharing the window of PictoBlock so that student can see that particular thing.
Sure.
Student, so I would ask you can maybe share just the PictoBlocks window, like in the sharing option, so that you can also see the chat at the same time.
Okay.
So students, you have to practice this particular thing in your PictoBlocks. And if you are not able to do it in this classroom simultaneously, you have the time till tomorrow to practice it. And so some of the doubts that I am seeing is, this is very similar to Scratch. So yes, this is definitely similar to Scratch, but it has a lot of extensions added into it, which allows it to you to create more programs, more different type of AI projects, interact with hardware and all those stuff you would be able to do. So I would ask to the students, how many of you have doubts cleared, and you are clear on what we have to whatever you learned during the session, how many of you are clear with it? Yeah, most of you are, I guess. Ayush, I can see a good number there.
Okay.
Yeah, Ayush, you can take ahead.
Yeah. So, like students, you just saw, we have explained you the things, how exactly it works on the laptop. So, but I would like to also show you some of the parts, how exactly it is going to work on Android. So just give me a moment.
Ayush, before going there, maybe you can just tell them how to save the program.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's a very important step, actually. I like to tell all the students that you need to save the program, and it's very necessary to do. So let me just show you how you can save it. So students, you can save the program. You can see there is a name written, My Project. So I'll just change this to Mission AI A1. Okay, and I can just directly click on this, and it will open where exactly I want to save the program. So I have dedicated folder where I save my all the projects, and I also want you to do so that you can keep track of what all the things you have done. Okay, so make a dedicated folder on your laptop or desktop and keep saving the projects here, and you can directly save it and the project will be saved. Okay. So I think this is very clear to all the students, because this is very important to save the project, okay? Because you will be in some time want to revise it or want to customize it or want to improve the program, you will be in need to open it. And how you can open it is you have to directly go to that folder. You have to directly just double click on that file and it will automatically open into the PictoBlocks. Okay, so I'll just share the presentation. Okay, so this was the things which we have just understood, but I'll just give you a short recap if in case you might have just missed some of the parts. So you can see these are the blocks in the blue, and you can see different colors in the different blocks. You can see a block palette. You can see a scripting area as well as the script. You can see different sprites. So on this, you can see there are two sprites, like a Toby, as well as one sprite is a drum. You can see a backdrop, which can be selected from the backdrop option. Now, here on the screen, you can also see the stage. Okay, so we also discussed about the stage. In the future, we will be learning about adding extensions and different parts, how we can do that. Now coming back to the mobile part, okay, so this is also very important, okay, and I would like to show you, although in the coming sessions, I will directly show my own Android screen and will try to show you how we can program and how we can do the things very easily in the Android. So once you will open the PictoBlocks, you are going to see this interface where there will be written as MySpace. So MySpace is a place where all your programs get saved. And also you can see there is a plus button, okay, on the bottom right corner, and you will also see a play button. So those, both of them are for guiding you, moving you to the main page of the PictoBlocks where you can write the codes. Now talking about the main page, you can see, so this is very important, students, because I know many of you are working with the Androids. Although you will be getting access to these presentations, it will be very much easier to see the things and relate it in your mobile. So here you can see that on this screen, so this is PictoBlocks from Android. So here you can see this is a back to home page arrow key, okay, on the, I should say, it's on the left side top corner. This arrow key helps you to just go back to the PictoBlocks page. And this purple line, you can understand it as a menu bar. And menu bar have a different options. So you can see at the center, it's an add sprite option. So if you want to add an sprite, just click on this, okay, and you will get an option to add an sprite from the library. It and the library is all the same as you saw in the laptop. So you can add your sprite using this option. If you want to select a backdrop, you have to click on this backdrop option, which is the first one. And again, there will be a small, I should say, edit option coming. When you are going to click on that, it will just bring up your like backdrop setting, and you can put the backdrop on the Android application as well. Also, you can see the options of full screen and a green flag here. And there is an option, like a button you can see, which helps you to show and hide the stage. So because in Android the screen is a little like not so big as a laptop or desktop, so you, if you want to do the programming easily, so you can also hide the stage whenever you want. So stage, you will be able to see it here. A very important button which you should remember is how to save. So students, you have to click on the save button whenever you are going or moving out of this screen. Okay, because like if you are working on picture blocks and suddenly you have moved out of it. Okay, so there might be chances that you lost the code what you have made. So what we want you to do is every time you complete a certain section of work, every time you complete a certain code, so after that, just click on the save button, okay, which is on the menu bar. The first button you can see, you have to just click on the save button, save the name, and then start working back on the file. So we have discussed all about this stage sprite, the stage palette, what are the different blocks and a block palette. Okay, so I'll just stop my slide, and if I would like to ask, like if you have any question, please feel free to ask me on the chat. I would be like good to answer them all. Okay. Just give me a, so what is the homework? So homework for today is like you have to do the hands-on, but there is no submission today, student. You don't have to do any submission today. We will be explaining you about the submission, how exactly you can do the submission. But also today you have to do a hands-on and make this activity. And how you are going to do is, I'll just let me give you a little idea. So we have already talked about everything in like how we are going to do in the laptop. But let me give you a little understanding how you are going to do it in mobile. So students, the first thing what you have to do is, this will give you a little, I should say, a recap. So first thing you have, you will be doing is you will be clicking on this add sprite option and you will be selecting a toggle. After that, students, as I said, the first step in the smartphone will be you have to click on this backdrop option. This will bring up this edit option. When you are going to click on this edit option, you will somewhere come in the place where you will see a backdrop setting page, where at the first option at the bottom corner, you will get an option to select the backdrop from the library. Okay, so I'll just explain you again. So you have to click on this backdrop, edit, and then in the backdrop setting, there is an option at the first position where you can, you have to click on that and you will be able to select the backdrop. So yeah, so as I said, today there would be no submissions, but we want all of you to like work with it, make the program, do the hands-on. We'll be letting you know about the how exactly you can submit the projects and how you are going to do the completing the assignment things in the coming. But I would also take 2 more minutes actually, because I have got some of the queries to me in the WhatsApp about like how the page look like, how exactly the things are. So I'll just take 2 more minutes to explain you this. So I'll just share my screen. So I hope my screen is visible. So students, this is the page, okay? Let me just go out of the window so that I can explain you each and everything here. Okay, so right now I'm logged in, so I'll just log out myself. So students who are using it in phone, okay, so you are going to see an option of menu. Okay, you are going to see an option of menu on the right hand side top corner. Okay, you have to click on that, and there you will be able to click on the, I should say, the login, and here you will come up on the login page. If you have completed the login, if you have not completed or registered till now, you have to click on register. So you have to fill this form, complete the registrations. When you have completed the registration, you will be automatically directed to the dashboard. So here you can see, I will just first log in. And as I, like we have already discussed that every time you have to log in, students, okay, don't register yourself. So now you can see, this is the page. So students, many of you might be facing some problem that I could not see the material, I could not see the assignment, or I could not see the links and everything. So mainly students who are using Android phone, just scroll this page, okay? Just scroll this page and you will be able to see this banner which says AI Bootcamp for Bash 2. Click on the explore more. This will basically take you inside the bootcamp. Okay, so right now you were into the dashboard page, and this is the batch 2 bootcamp page. Okay, so this is batch 2 bootcamp page, and here you can see the live sessions link. Okay, so every time if you have not kept it saved somewhere, so you can get your link from here. You can download the PictoBlocks for your PC, for your smartphone. And if, as I, like we have already told you, if you have finding a compatibility issue, you can download the app from directly this link. Also, we have given you an option to ask your questions. So this is a small form. Okay, every time, anytime you are finding a trouble, want to ask something to us. So just click on this form, okay, and you can ask us all the questions. Also, you can see the recorded video here. Okay, so every session recording, you will be able to see it here, and you will be able to see the sessions here. Okay, so this is two step, you can understand. So this is a batch 2 bootcamp page, okay? And this is a dashboard page. So you, once you are coming to the dashboard, you have to click this banner, which will guide you to the bootcamp, AI Bootcamp Batch 2 page. And here you will be able to see all the materials, assignments, the links, and the live sessions. Okay. And we will try to get this updated ASAP. So yeah, this was all from my side to cover. So anything other than this, Pankaj sir, do you want me to cover? Sir, you are not audible to us.
Yeah, I think it's all good. I just wanted to ask with the students, is everything clear to them? So today you don't have to submit the assignment. The assignment submission will start from tomorrow, but you have to work on PictoBlocks. You have to work aggressively on whatever you have learned today. You are learning it, you are able to understand it and do that as well. And we will upload the video onto the portal. So you can go there, you can see the video of the, and if some of you have missed any session during the coming sessions, then don't worry, go back to the portal. The video will be uploaded there. You can see the video, you can go through the whole session and do the assignment as well. So it's very important that if you miss the session, then you see the recording and do the activity as well. And I guess with the amount of engagement that we are getting from you, we will be getting a very good result in terms of the understanding of you increasing in AI and the project making ability as well. So I think we would be able to do a lot when we start our competition as well. So I think it's good to go from Pramod sir.
I just want to say one thing, and which is just repeat what you and Ayush has said. Today is the foundation day for the boot camp. So today, no assignment, but the today's assignment is you become familiar with picture block, as Pankaj said. The better you understand it, better you'll understand what we teach you tomorrow. So, yes, it is very important for today. Download picture block. Go through all the commands on the left. Try and understand what is there. And then tomorrow when they are being shown how to use them, you'd understand very fast. So, thumbs up everybody. Good response today. But now go and make yourself ready to start learning everything new. One new thing a day you will start learning now. You will learn vision, you will learn speech, you learn so many things, you learn game. So I leave that to Ayush. It was a very exciting journey which is starting from tomorrow. Thank you, Ayush. Thank you, Pankaj. This is a good camp. Let's get the students really up to the mark. And like I was saying, this Mission AI is very important. What we are trying is not just giving the education. We are making you ready to use AI every day in your life. From today itself, whichever class you are in, you will understand as much AI which is required so that you can start using AI. After some time, you see, you'll be able to make your smart car, you may be able to make your smart home, you'll be able to do a lot of things like Dr. Prem said, which will happen. So, yes, from tomorrow, it will be full screen, but today the foundation has to be very strong. So, as Pankaj and Ayush repeatedly said, download picture blocks, go through all the commands, become familiar, try, experiment. This is how you learn. So, thank you everybody for being with us. And we hope that this will create a lot of good AI specialists in this country. So thank you, everybody. We look forward to you learning something every day and learning with each other. So that is good. We'll tell you about that tomorrow. Thank you, Pankaj. Thank you, Ayush.
Thank you. Thank you.
That is enough for me.
And tomorrow, we will have this class at same time, 3 to 4. And the joining link will be the same, so you can join in with the same link that you have joined with today. So the link will be the same, and you can also get the link from your bootcamp page as well. So thank you everyone for joining in, and if you have any question, we have a doubt form there as well. Just fill the doubt form and you can ask the questions to us. Thank you everyone.